I am Rafael Molina from the University of Alicante. This is a doctoral work of our student Alberto Real, and the thesis has been supervised by Farah Llorens and me. The question here was, we started with the same definition of smart learning that we presented in the presentation of the track. So we want to build a learning model based on technology that can detect the student individual situation, the context, the learning style, the needs, the state of the learning, and adapt the activities to this situation. So this is our conceptual structure. We have a student which is characterized by a feature vector. We have activities that are characterized with the characteristics, with the feature of the activities. We also have a teacher. We may have a learning strategy. And we have an artificial intelligence algorithm that should be able to take all these elements into account and select what is the most suitable activity to be performed. Okay? Somehow it's similar to the concept of the work presented by Adolfo. In this paper, we are focus this part on the proposal of a set of instructional strategies that are selectable by the teacher, configurable by parameters, that acts as a guide to the algorithm, to the artificial intelligence algorithm, to select the most suitable activity, considering the teacher preferences. Because many times the artificial intelligence algorithms are not assumed by some people because they think that it's a black box and the teacher has nothing to say. But we want the teacher to use this algorithm, but to select a strategy for this algorithm to act. So we have first, we have defined a learner model. A learner model is a set of information obtained and retained by the learning system about the learner. This information is very wide. It can be of different types. We have behavioral information about how the student behaves during the learning tasks. Time spent, starting time, time interruptions, things of activity, and so on. We use the student activity log in the platform, in the system, to obtain this data. We have also performance information, which is the learning status, the level of skills in the learning process. The achieved skills, time taken to complete activities, completed activities, successful or unsuccessful activities, and so on. This is obtained from the activity log, but also from the learning outcomes from the system. Mm-hmm. And finally, which is more difficult to obtain, is the personal information. This information that depends only on the learner, and it's independent from the system. So it's quite difficult to catch it from the system. It's about learning goals, background, motivational state, preferences, personality, chronotypes, and so on. We want to obtain that from the student behavior in the system and from the learning style instruments. It's not easy. We are now studying this question. Okay? We also have the activity model. The activity model in this case is set of information obtained by a learning system, but in this case about the activities. We have some type of test, information about difficulty, how difficult is the activity to the learner, time spent to do it, starting time in time, is quite similar to the behavior of the student. The source is the teacher evaluation. The evaluation, the teacher has to evaluate how difficult is a activity, but also it can be evaluated automatically or even by the students. If you have many students doing the activity, you can approximate how difficult they are looking at the time they spend doing this activity and the results. We also have levels of reasoning skills to perform the activity. We are talking about cognitive dimension. This is based on the Bloom taxonomy. Remember, understand, apply this type of character. This is mainly from the teacher. And finally, the learning style. The learning style is the suitability to be performed by learners to have a particular learning style. The learning style belongs to the student, but you can detect which activities are more suitable to improve this learning style. There are many theories about that, and it requires the evaluation of the teacher or the kind of expert. So, we want to obtain feature vectors from these models. These models must be prepared for automatic processing. So you have to convert these features that are quite general to vectors in my mathematical sense, okay? We talk about features, which are explanatory variables that are used to characterize an aspect of the phenomenon. They must be measurable, meaningful, discriminating, and independent. These are the main characteristics of a feature. And we also have the feature vector, which is a set of variables of this kind. To calculate these vectors, what we do is to apply these features to activities, but not to individuals. So that the learning vector is created as a consequence of the activity, the actions in the learning system, and the results of the activity. So, we have the learning model, we have an activity bag, the selection engine selects an activity, and the learner performs the activity. So that the results of the activity and this activity vector is updates the learning model, okay, in a cycle. In this point, what we want to introduce in the selection machine, in this selection engine, is the instructional strategy, which is a set of approaches, models, techniques, and methods that the teacher uses to optimize the learning process. To be computed, they must be converted to a set of guidelines that can be treated by the algorithm. So we propose this structure. We propose what we call the dimensions. The dimensions are the specific aspects of the strategy on which we want to obtain a result. We define the tactics as each value that a dimension can take. And finally, the combination of dimensions and tactics is the learning strategy. And to obtain that, what we do is to combine some variables, which are the variables to get the desired effect are belonging to each dimension. We can see a proposal, three proposals. For instance, those are the possible dimensions that we have considered: mental state, learning objectives, learning styles, cognitive levels, long-term memory, and those are the possible tactics. For instance, we want to take a state of flow and learning objectives from reinforcement. And we use those variables to obtain these tactics. This is one particular example. For instance, a strategy could be flow to obtain a mental state of flow to make to enhance reinforcement as a learning objective, variety for the learning styles, or repetition for the long memory. So the conclusion: the smart learning systems. We have defined this system to adapt the learning process to the learner. The selection of the next activity by this selection engine depends on these factors: the competencies that have already developed, the competencies to be developed, the available activities, the student features, and finally, the instructional strategy that is selected by the teachers. These strategies are a set of guidelines given by the teachers so that the right activities could be selected. It's an open model, multidimensional. There are many tactics. No dimension is compulsory, so it can be as wide as we want. And finally, it's adaptable to almost any objective that the teacher wants to obtain from their students.